In this video, I'd like to demonstrate a useful feature of the Design Variable Explorer that may not be intuitive to a lot of users. And that is that you can find variables that aren't necessarily displayed over here in, say, a component menu. So let me demonstrate. We can come to the section tab of this wing component, and we can click on the span variable, and that will tell you the name of the parameter, the group that it's in, and where to find it. So if we come here to cross section one, we can find span, and then we can add that in. But not all parameters that are available in OpenVSP have this feature. So for example, you can't click on the twist reference button and have it bring up the parameter and tell you how to choose between relative or absolute. So where is that? How do you find it? What if you want to control that? Well, you can come to your group container. And in this case, these are found in the wing geom. And if you click on the parm, you can see that your relative dihedral, relative twist, rotate airfoil to match dihedral, all of that is found here. So if we click on relative twist flag, add that variable. Now under adjust, you can see that we have an acceptable value of 0 or 1. So watch what happens. As I'm moving this between 0 and 1, which is either a false or true, it's swapping between relative and absolute over here in twist. And that's a very simple example of how to find something that's not very intuitive as to where that parameter lives. Let's look at another one that a lot of you are probably interested in. Instead of the wing, let's come down here to VSP Aero settings and then pick any of the available parameters in VSP Aero. So in this case, you can turn actuator disks on or off, change the time steps, set your Mach values, number of points, etc., all from the design variable file. And not only is this useful for setting up design variable files, but it helps you locate and isolate where these hidden parameters are within your OpenVSP file so that you can intuitively and intelligently set up your scripts instead of trying to hunt for what the name of that parameter is. It will tell you the container, the group, and the parameter name, and that is all you need to be able to interactively adjust this stuff or set it up in a script.